going on, guys? It is your boy Jason Love coming at you with another video about non-CDL and CDL Hotshot. In this video, like every video, I'm going to be talking about something that's super important. So last video, if you guys haven't seen it, I talked about non-CDL Hotshots not needing IFTA or IRP, apportioned plates. And I had a couple questions about GVWR. People didn't really understand what it was. And so I want to make this video kind of just explaining exactly what GVWR is so that you guys can understand it and so that we can all be on the same page. Before I do that though, I want to say thank you to all my subscribers. If you don't know, we are doing a 500 subscriber giveaway. We are about 115 away, so let's just keep grinding and we can get there pretty soon and give away some awesome merch and some other stuff. It's gonna be super dope. So yeah, guys, if you're not subscribed, please subscribe to the channel. It helps me out a lot. Okay, so understanding GVWR. So GVWR stands for gross vehicle weight rating. Okay, so let's say, for example, you have a 2019 Ford F-350 dually, okay? The GVWR for 2019 Ford F-350 dually is 14,000 pounds. That does not mean that that dually weighs 14,000 pounds. That dually is probably going to weigh 8,500 pounds. But the GVWR is the gross vehicle weight rating. So basically, it says that that vehicle is rated to weigh up to 14,000 pounds. That being said, that means that you in the truck, if you have maybe 10 other friends in the truck, if you fill the bed up with something, that you can't weigh more than 14,000 pounds, okay? Because that's what the truck's rated for, okay? Now, to find your GVWR, you're going to open up the door of your truck. You should have, like, the VIN plate right there. It's going to tell you your GVWR. It could be 11,000 pounds, 12,000 pounds, 14,000 pounds, you know, for said truck. Now, under the 14,000 pounds, you're going to have the axle GVWRs. So it's actually going to split up that 14,000 into two axles, okay? But usually, if you add up the axle GVWRs, it's going to be more than 14,000 pounds. But even though those axles can handle more weight or are rated for more weight, you still can't go over the 14,000 pounds. That's something that's important. So GVWR is not actually what your truck weighs, but it's what your truck's rated to weigh. Okay, if you can understand that. Same with your trailer, right? So you might have a trailer that has a GVWR of 12,000 pounds if you're non-CDL, right? So basically that says that that trailer cannot weigh more than 12,000 pounds. That's what it's rated for. Now that trailer may only weigh 7,200 pounds, okay? So if you combine the trailer that has a GVWR of 12,000 pounds and you combine the truck that has a GVWR of 14,000 pounds, you then have a combined GVWR of 26,000 pounds, and you can be a non-CDL hotshot, for example. Now, if you actually weigh your setup might only weigh, you know, let's say 16,000 pounds, for example, then you have 10,000 pounds that you can load onto that trailer to still be under your combined GVWR of 26,000 pounds. Now, if you guys have the question, how can I put 10,000 pounds on a trailer, on a 7,000 pound trailer that has a GVWR of 12,000 pounds? Well, I'll put my video right here. Go ahead and watch that. I explained that whole thing on how that works and how you get weighed by the axles. But yeah, so GVWR, simply put, it's just the rating, okay? If you're gonna do non-CDL hotshot, you cannot exceed a GVWR of over 26,000 pounds, and you cannot weigh more than 26,000 pounds. I have seen people, I saw this guy who posted on a Facebook page, he actually had a CDL, his truck's GVWR was 11,000 pounds, and his trailer's GVWR was 14,000 pounds, so in essence, he could only load up to, he could only weigh combined 25,000 pounds, so even though he was a CDL hotshot, his equipment did not allow him to even hit 26,000 pounds, okay, if you are a CDL hotshot, you could have a truck that's 14,000 pounds GVWR and a trailer that's 20,000 pounds GVWR. That means your combined GVWR is 34,000 pounds. What that means is loaded or unloaded, anything, you cannot weigh more than 34,000 pounds. Even though your truck might be able to pull 10,000 pounds more or your trailer may be able to handle more weight, it doesn't matter. Your GVWR is 34,000 pounds. That means you cannot weigh more than 34,000 pounds. Same thing goes with semi trucks. You know, they might have GVWR of 80,000 pounds, and then that's how much combined on the scales they can weigh, 80,000 pounds. So yeah, guys, I hope you can understand this video. GVWR really isn't that hard to understand. It's just the rating, you know, the rating for your truck and the rating for your trailer. If you're non-CDL, your rating cannot be over 26,000 pounds. If you're CDL, it really just depends on the equipment you have. And that's basically it, guys. That's GVWR. I hope you can understand the video. If you guys still have questions about it, leave a comment, like the video. You know, it helps me out a ton when you guys do such things, and I love reading your questions. I love making videos about your questions. I love answering your questions. You know, that's what really makes me happy, is I can help you learn new things. I can help you make your business more successful. That's what makes me happy. So I love you guys so much. I thank you for the support you give me, and I hope you all have a great day.